leadership is very important in digital transformation. But I want to go back again to what I mentioned regarding this study on how, what are the top five benefits of the digital transformation. I think a while ago, it was mentioned by Andrea how leaders has affected and the followers in terms of these five benefits. So again, just wanted to show the improvement of the profit margin in terms of the digital transformation. A while ago, it showed the graph between leaders and followers. Now is how it's going to grow in the next 3 years. So improvement in profit margin, greater productivity, increase in revenues from new products and services, greater customer advocacy or loyalty retention, and of course, improvement in cost reduction. So this is definitely going to impact the whole business. Overall, there's significant and tangible improvements. And I think from the Philippine side, you saw a while ago in GDP from 3% going 18% and 40%. Now we realize in that study alone as well, we see that in Philippines, I think the range from 6 to 12% in terms of increase of profitability and productivity. So that's very significant. And at the same time, the growth in the next 3 years, as approximately forecasted by IDC, more than 50% in 3 years, and better, more improvement in the margins and productivity. Okay. So in addition, many organizations are trying to streamline their operations and improve productivity. First, while of course, increasing investment in analytics or AI, just to make sure to drive customer loyalty and retention. This is very important because that is the base customers of our organization. And again, make sure, remember the top five benefits what this study has brought about, because these are key for leadership, for leaders, to make sure that they're able to present this in the roadmap. Also, I mentioned about, aside from the specific benefits, are the challenges. So I think a while ago from the leadership presentation, the leaders and followers, you will see an array of what things needs to be done. But at the same time, challenges, especially here in Philippines, it's very important. Number one, I think lack of the skills and resources. Do you agree? You agree? And even, I think, from a media perspective, you should be able to also to see the short of supply and resources. But again, this is very relevant. Why? Because in every technologies that we see, having to retool or upskill talent and retaining talent is a perennial issue. And of course, the resources right now are short of supply. At the same time, very, very expensive. Again, very expensive. So it's very important that this number one challenge is at the top of mind of leadership of an organization. Again, in the cybersecurity, as we all know, will always be a problem. New threats, growing threats, heightened risks. You will see example. I think later you'll see how also Union Bank is trying to make sure that they are secure given the new and emerging technologies. And just to mention the third one, which is very relevant in Philippines, is finding the right technology partner or a strategic partner as you go to this journey of digital transformation. I think that is very important. And if you will see in large scale organizations like conglomerates, culture to add in is also something that needs a challenge for a lot of for Filipinos or Philippine organization. Because culture cannot be bought by pesos or dollars. Culture requires change of leadership, vision, values, and at the same time, how the management team will be able to cut across organization in implementing change. And as you all know, in a lot of the approaches right now in digital transformation, I don't know if you've heard about fail fast, learn fast approaches, which is a growing approach in digital transformation. I think this is very hard to implement in traditional organization right now. So, just to add more on how we are looking at digital transformation in each organization, traditionally, we have business metrics, which is profit margins, market share, sales volume. These are traditional KPIs for us to understand if our business is moving forward or we're gaining growth in our industry. But there, in digital transformation, there are some positive outcomes that come from digitalization. And in that, we should be able to monitor and track what are we doing. So the new KPIs like data as capital asset, customer advocacy, employee advocacy, this should be able to complement the traditional KPIs. And you'll be surprised as well in the IDC study, respondents that part of that study, we see that 66% already included their KPI on process and service effectiveness. And 53% as well using data as a capital asset to grow revenues, business models, and improve productivity. And in Philippines, a lot of the organizations, 56% see customer advocacy, loyalty retention, as part of the KPI to monitor if digital transformation is really happening within the organization. And it's touching lives of the customers and partners. So these new KPIs is very important and strategic as our leaders continue to drive digital transformation. So we also add up in this slide to categorize the set of technology investment for digital transformation. As you can see, we want to set it as core and emerging. Simply because if we will not invest in core technology and like cloud, data, big data analytics, mobility, and even security, emerging technologies will not make sense in the greater scheme of things. Without big data analytics, AI, or machine learning, or robotics will definitely be impossible, because all of these emerging technologies require data, and data acquisition, data sharing, value development and realization are all critical for AI technologies to be implemented. And without cloud, organizations will not have access to high power computing and storage, which supports big data analytics. So you've heard about mobile first, cloud first. Yes, we should be at that stage right now for all of the organization. But emerging technologies will lead us to intelligent cloud and intelligent edge. And that is really the core and essence of digital transformation. So for you to hear firsthand the digital transformation journey of Union Bank, let me welcome Arvi De Vera, the head of the FinTech Group of Union Bank. Arvi,